and welcome back to Proactive Investors. Joining me now from Polymetals Resources is Chairman Dave Sproule. Dave, welcome to the program. Glad to have you here.
Thank you, Elisha.
Dave, some news out from the Endeavour zinc, lead and silver mine this week. You've just announced up to 32% zinc equivalent in some mining activity here. Tell us all about the exploration and what you're hoping to achieve.
Polymetals initiated its due diligence of the Endeavour project in April of last year. It's been a long process. We've done a lot of work, that culminated in the acquisition of the operation from CBH Resources. North Lode, or the Upper North Lode, is a zone that's been known of for many years. It has a great deal of oxide. It's a mixed bag, oxide, massive sulfides, and the like. The oxide material for us is of particular interest, given that there are hydrometallurgical solutions to recovering particularly silver gold from that region. So the upper zone above the RL 1080 should contain somewhere north of 500,000 tonnes of mineralisation. These intercepts come as no surprise, but what is good to see are the broad gold intercepts contained within this material.
Certainly a shot in the arm for you and the team. Now, while this acquisition has been months in the making, Polymetals is no stranger to the Cobar Basin. Tell us about the broader potential in this region.
Myself and my family initially were involved in the Cobar region from 1992. In fact, Polymetals, as the private company back then, purchased a tailing material from the Endeavour mine that was actually mined from the upper south lode, some 100 metres south of the north lode that we're currently testing. We treated that material to recover economic gold and silver, and that's really what got the Polymetals, the private company, on its feet in the early 90s. So we've been associated in the region with the Mount Poppy gold mine for many years. We put the Mayday R&D mine together in 1997. We had a second campaign of gold mining at Mount Poppy, which is located 50 kilometres to the east of Cobar. And then we purchased and put the Manuka silver operation together in 2014-15. So no strangers to the Cobar region. Have known of the Endeavour mine for many years. First met the president of Toho Zinc in Tokyo in 2014, maintained a relationship with Toho Zinc, who privatised CBH Resources in 2010. And so the operation was operated from 2010 through to 2019 under private ownership.
And if I'm not mistaken, part of Endeavour's appeal is really the key infrastructure that's already here. Could you outline some of the project's possibilities and what this asset really could add to your portfolio?
There's a great deal of infrastructure available with this project. So there's a 1.2 million tonne per annum flotation plant, 5 megawatts of grinding capacity, an underground mine down to 1,000 metres, 42 houses and 4 blocks of units and other real estate in the township of Cobar. But our aim is not to allow the size of the infrastructure to drive the output from this project. Sure, there's a great deal of infrastructure there. There's a great deal of flexibility there. But the mining and concentrating on high-grade material that's available to us is the key from our perspective to ensuring that we restart a profitable and long-term project.
All right, Dave, so Endeavour is another feather in your cap, and I'm sure investors will be keen to know what's next for you in the project.
There's a great deal of work to be done. Rome wasn't built in a day. We have an excellent platform of assets here and certainly mineralisation and resources at hand. There's an amount of exploration that's required and mine studies and also following up in-mine gold intercepts that are yet to be further tested. So what we're doing right now, Alicia, is we're looking at the most cost-effective and timely means of pulling sufficient ore reserves together To ensure that when this project is restarted, that may be within the next 18 to 24 months, that we have long-term production and profitable production ahead of us. So the regional exploration potential is very good also. There are many geochemical and geophysical targets that have been sparsely tested over the many years that this Cobar Basin exploration has been live. In fact, we have intercepts or geochemical anomalies that were found some 50 years ago that are yet to be tested today with today's metal prices. So a lot of work to be done. We are a production-focused company. That's our DNA. And we hope to bring this project back online in a timely and measured basis, having applied the science and shareholders' funds wisely, to ensure that we get it right. So that's our current intention.
Dave, we appreciate the opportunity to chat to you about precious and base metal exploration at this underloved asset. And we look forward to hearing what's next for you and the Endeavour mine. Chat again soon.
Thank you, Alicia.